Hi beautiful people, you welcome back to our channel. According to a video shared online by Governor Yahaya's aide Jumabi, where an unrepentant Kogi-based beggar returned back to the streets months after receiving help from Jumabi. According to Jumabi, who shared the story and videos on his Instagram page, the woman sold everything and returned to the streets with her children to beg. Jumabi is the SSA on entertainment to the Kogi State Governor, and he wrote, "Be careful who you help. If you are familiar with Kogi environment, you will definitely know this woman. So sometime last year during my birthday celebration, I was stuck in London due to a pandemic, but I got my team to celebrate in my absence, and of course they visited orphanages, shared items for the vulnerables, and I told myself that the only birthday gift I wanted was to take this woman and her kids off the street. So we got her an apartment, furnished it in her own capacity, and gave her a token to start a small-scale business. Sadly, she left the house in less than 2 weeks and sold all the items in the house. But she ran out of luck when a charity organization reached out to me on Facebook that they did the same thing for her and even went as far as enrolling her kids in a private school, but she withdrew them and sold the items in her house again. So guys, I am pushing this video out not for anything, but for everyone not to think we didn't fulfill our promises as she's back on the street. So obviously this is a game for her. Be careful guys, things they happen for Naija." Reacting to the video, one Saturday journey wrote, it is as if they never get any satisfaction from staying off the street. Calling on her mental health to be checked, one Chukwu Ebuka Isaac wrote, "She needs a mental rehabilitation. Stop insulting her people. Her condition messed with her prior to when she got help, but when don't take mental health very seriously in this country, you can force this off her." One Harless Enroy wrote, "If you know how much beggars make, you know why they won't stop. They are so comfortable making money without doing nothing." Another social media user wrote, "Begging is a huge business in Nigeria, so helping a beggar even with all the basic things never gets him or her satisfied. Some beggars even get money past the people giving them. I'd rather help an organization or pay someone's hospital bill than giving my money to all these self-acclaimed street beggars." Here is the video.
"Madam, how are you?
Fine, sir.
Do you know me?
No.
Well, come on, tell you something.
What do you mean?
I was the one in London.
Yes.
During my birthday last year. That sent money for you to rent a house.
Yes, sir.
That bought everything in the house.
Yeah.
In that house, I put everything in that house for you.
Yes, sir.
Because I saw your condition.
Yes,
I said I wanted to make you my own birthday present. I put you in the house.
Yes,
sir. Put TV in the house, Abi, for you to be comfortable.
Yes, sir.
They sent me a video, my entire Kogi team, they were all with you for my birthday. Then they said 2 weeks later you gave the house out and came back to the street.
Daddy.
What happened?
Yeah,
what happened?
Yes,
and before that time, somebody sent me a message on Facebook that they saw this woman, that they gave you a house again. One organization, a non-governmental organization, gave you a house, and that you sold the house to somebody else again. I didn't know.
It's not so.
So how can I put you in the house and you leave the house,
Daddy,
and come back to the street?
Daddy, wait. Let me say now. Daddy, I managed to hustle the GIT exam successfully. I asked her, I said, please, this man that's Jim, please give us his number. Let's talk to him. A man who can do this for us can also help us today. I've been praying. I used to ask your boys, please, where is there's a day I came to that gate. They said your house is opposite the government house. I asked those escorts that nobody, they said you are, the you people are running. So this girl now did it. Even the school self, Daddy. Activities wanted to, and now somebody came here, good Samaritan, now helped me. I changed her to Amide. Now, Daddy, our problem we have now, just what?
The house.
The house?
Yes.
So, I came to explain to the landlord. So, I now got a place at this Umoro. That place, there is market. But, Daddy, no finance.
I want to leave this place. I don't want you to come here again. That's my problem.
I think you are back now.
Well, I'm back. Yes. I'm going for when I come back from where I'm going to the afternoon.
Yes, sir.
One of my boys will follow you. Go and show them this new house.
Oh, Daddy, I will show them.
Then it's a big business you want to do.
Yes.
I don't ever want to see. If I see you here again.
Daddy, if you see me, lock
if
me.
I see you here again.
Yes, lock me. Even this woman at first, she came in. This woman I explained for when she saw all these things, the house of Daddy. I was buying shako from village. I go to this Basa TV. If I buy it 800, Daddy, I will bring it. If I sell 1.5, I will tie, Daddy.
But you were not supposed to come back to this place. That's my only problem.
No, Daddy. I told you that. I said, and this boy, just for this boy not to follow bad groups. That is why I came.
Like today, we are going to be giving out a whole house, complete home, to a widow. The widow has been sleeping on the street in Galaya Junction with two kids, and that alone speaks volume of who Jumabi is.
On behalf of our brother who celebrated his birthday today, this is the key to your new apartment.